Let's practice finding derivatives for functions that involve trig. So number one, find dy dx for y equals e to the 3x times cosine x. So to find this derivative, we're going to need to use the product rule because we have the product of two functions. We have e to the 3x and we have cosine x. So before we dive in and take the derivative of this function as a whole, let's quickly just think about the derivative of each piece separately. We'll just look at that out to the side here. So remember this rule that the derivative of e to the ax, where a represents a number, is a e to the ax. So that's the form we have here with e to the 3x. So the derivative of e to the 3x is just going to be 3e to the 3x. Okay, what about the derivative of cosine? Well, the derivative of cosine of x is negative sine of x. So using those pieces, let's try and find the derivative of this entire function, y equals e to the 3x times cosine x. Okay, so dy dx equals, now we're going to use a product rule, and you may have a different order for remembering it than I do, but the way I remember it is first times the derivative of the second plus second times the derivative of the first. So in this case, that'd be first e to the 3x times the derivative of the second plus the second times the derivative of the first. Okay, and then let's go ahead and plug in those derivatives. So that's going to be e to the 3x times the derivative of cosine, which we said was negative sine, plus cosine times the derivative of e to the 3x, which is 3e to the 3x. Now, if I want to, I can simplify this a little bit, because both terms have a factor of e to the 3x, so I can factor that out, bring it out front. So that would give me e to the 3x times a quantity. I'm going to put this 3, sorry, this should be cosine x in the previous line, cosine x times 3e to the 3x. Okay, so I'm factoring the e to the 3x out front. That's going to leave me with a 3 cosine x minus a sine x. And this is my derivative. Number two, find dy dx for y equals 4 sine x minus x cosine x. Okay, so this function is made up of two pieces. First, we have 4 sine x. That's not going to be too bad to take the derivative of. The 4 is just a constant, so we'll just be able to pull that out front. Now, x cosine x, we're going to have to use the product rule on that. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started. Dy dx equals. Okay, 4 sine x. The 4 is just a constant multiple. It just gets to stay. And then we need the derivative of sine of x. The derivative of sine is cosine of x minus, okay, I'm going to go ahead and put this derivative in brackets because when I go back through and simplify this, I want to remember to distribute that subtraction sign to the product rule, the multiple pieces of the product rule. Okay, so the derivative of x cosine x. So the product rule, that's going to be first times the derivative of the second plus the second times the derivative of the first. Okay, so let's work on simplifying inside of the brackets first. So we have 4 cosine x minus this entire quantity. So I have x times the derivative of the cosine. So the derivative of the cosine is negative sine x. Then I have plus cosine x times the derivative of x. But the derivative of x is just 1. Okay, so still working inside those parentheses, or sorry, inside those brackets. This first term is minus x sine x, and then I have plus cosine x. All right, now that we've simplified inside the brackets, let's go ahead and distribute that subtraction sign. So that's going to give me 4 cosine x. So here I've got minus a minus, so that's going to be plus x sine x, and then minus cosine x. Now we can do just a little bit more simplification here because I have 4 cosine x minus cosine x. So that's going to give me 3 cosine x overall. Okay, so this is going to be 3 cosine x plus x sine x. And that's my final answer for this one. All right, number 3. Find dy dx for y equals 1 plus cosine x over 1 minus cosine x. So this is a quotient. I'm going to need to use the quotient rule to find the derivative. So let's go ahead and dive right in. Dy dx equals. So the way I remember the quotient rule is bottom times the derivative of the top minus top times the derivative of the bottom over the bottom squared. So if I write that out, I've got bottom 1 minus cosine x times the derivative of the top 1 plus cosine x minus top 1 plus cosine x times the derivative of the bottom 1 minus cosine x. And that's all over the bottom squared. So 1 minus cosine x squared. Okay, so we have some derivatives to take on the top. So I have the quantity 1 minus cosine x times the derivative of 1 plus cosine x. Well, the derivative of 1 is just 0. So I'm left with the derivative of cosine, and the derivative of cosine is negative sine. So this is negative sine x. Okay, minus 1 plus cosine x times the derivative of 1 minus cosine x. So once again, the derivative of 1 is 0. So I have the derivative of cosine x, which is negative sine, but it's minus negative sine. So double negative gives me a positive, and this is going to be sine x. Okay? And that's all over 1 minus cosine x quantity squared. Okay, so let's see if anything is going to cancel out on the top. So let's go ahead and distribute everything. So here I've got negative sine times the quantity 1 minus cosine. Okay, so I'm going to distribute this to both terms. That's going to give me negative sine x plus cosine x sine x. And then same thing for the second set of parentheses. I'm going to distribute this sine to both terms. And remember, I'm subtracting this entire quantity. So minus sine x minus sine x cosine x. Cosine x sine x all over 1 minus cosine x quantity squared. Okay, so I see that actually I can simplify a little bit because I have this plus cosine x sine x minus cosine x sine x. And then what I'm left with is 2 minus sine x's. So that's going to be negative 2 sine x on top and then 1 minus cosine x squared on the bottom. And this is our derivative.